presentation, we're doing Dystocia and Mayors. I'm Allie Grimion.
I'm Caitlin.
I'm Gretchen.
Dystocia is a very stressful event when a difficult birth occurs due to improper fetal position, posture, or presentation of the pelvic canal. It can happen to all species, but dystocia is very prevalent in mares and is the least successful compared to other species. It occurs in about 1% of equine birds and is most common in mares during their first foaling. Causes can include smaller malformed birth canal, falling pelvic fractures or injuries, or just an overall inexperienced mare. Older mares can have this as well. Hydropic conditions, which is excess birth fluid. Twinning, where both fetuses are trying to come out at the same time. And fetal oversize. This is not common in horses, but it can happen. And fetal malformation, where the fetus is just malformed and can't come out normally.
Some warning signs that dystocia might occur and that you may need to contact your veterinarian would be to see a bright red sac. This is not like the pink color that you would normally see, but this is a truly bright red. That would be the placenta being detached. In that case, the foal is not getting any oxygen, and that is a sign that you need to act immediately in order to save the foal and the mare, potentially. Another warning sign would be excess fluid coming through her cervix, and she's not like a small amount of fluid, like when her waters are released, but excessive fluid over a long length of time. Signs that look a lot like colic, very not normal distress from labor, but violent, very violent signs, colic signs or distress, or in lack of signs that she's in labor. If she's depressed, if she's not doing anything, if she's not pushing, that would be another sign that you need to contact your veterinarian that something's very wrong. Most of these signs they present without warning other than the day of. You don't have, 48 hours of warning that dystocia is probably going to happen. You have to act quickly in the moment. And it's advisable to have your veterinarian with you if it's your first mare's pregnancy or a first foal for you as well. Defective fetus as well can be an issue. If you saw in the ultrasound, it's defective in some way or dead, that is another sign that you'll probably have dystocia during the birth. If the fetus is dead, if you can tell that it is dead, that is another issue. If you see the head but not the feet, if you see the butt, if you see the hind legs or just one leg, all of those are signs that you need to contact your veterinarian and that the mare will have issues during her delivery.
One of the reasons that mares have more difficulty during pregnancy is because of how long-lived the foals can be. Horses are not as balanced as some other livestock animals that we have, and so one of the biggest problems is incorrect presentation of the fetus. A lot of these are mainly because of the longer-lived nature of the animal. Some examples are incomplete elbow extension, dog sitting or hurdling position, carpal flexion or contracture, foot over neck position, head and neck lateral flexion, head and neck ventral flexion, shoulder flexion, and more, and I will show you these on the next slide. Actually, I like This is the correct presentation of a foal. This is what we want them to look like in the pelvic canal. We want the amniotic sac to be present around their front hooves. We want the front hooves and head to be protruding from the pelvic canal whenever she is getting ready to give birth. And we basically want them in a straight, arched position outward so that it's easy to remove them without any complications. These are some of the ones that we discussed earlier. As you can see, if you have only one leg extended, then you risk the possibility of dislocating or breaking a shoulder. If you have no legs extended, you're going to have to pull on the head, which can cause a lot of complications, as you can imagine. Sometimes they have the legs in incorrect positioning, which, once again, risks dislocating or breaking a bone. For breaking a neck. We have the head backwards, which almost looks like his neck is broken already, but same situation, you're going to have more difficulty getting it out without crushing his airways. You have some that are completely presenting upside down, some where their feet, their hind legs, are also towards the front, which makes it harder to elongate them out to the correct position. Completely backwards is whenever you really need to go to a cesarean section, say for this situation where you're upside down, or either of these as well, because you don't want to risk hurting the foal while you're trying to birth it or hurting the mare in the process.
In a study done by Colorado State University, it was found that thoroughbreds have a more difficult time with labor and therefore more rates of higher rates of dystocia than thoroughbreds and other smaller breeds. This could be attributed, and their conclusion was that the longer limbs of the thoroughbred that we have over time bred, since they're taller, faster, stronger for the racing industry, that they have more issues than quarter horses whose legs are naturally a little bit more proportioned to their body. Another reason could be as well, the dystocia in mares and thoroughbreds particularly, could be that the energy level and the feed given to a thoroughbred mare is typically higher than that of a quarter horse, and so they're more they're naturally more anxious, they have more energy to burn, and while that's wonderful on a racetrack, in a pregnant mare that can distress their labor and cause it to stop, halt, or even cause problems. Thankfully, most of the race horse industry and the stables that they researched at, they had very competent equine staff, and so they were able to help the 40% of thoroughbred mares that did have dystocia. That is a significant jump from the overall horse population, which only has a 1% reported dystocia. Of course, that could be higher from smaller private farms or private homes, but reported nationally in the last about 10 years, it's only been about 1%. However, one author and resident equine student has said that it might be only 1% of the problem, but when it is your 1%, it's 100% of a problem if your mare is having that issue, and that it is an issue that will have to be met and dealt with immediately and have no warning. That is part of the reason why it is a bigger problem in mares than perhaps cattle, although statistically that's not what you find. Cattle are bred more often, they have more foals than we would breed horses typically, and so the fact that they have more births means that they might have more difficulties. But I imagine if you were to take a statistician and to see the same number of births in horses and the same number of births in cattle, I imagine the rate would be higher, and that's certainly what they found in the study from Colorado State University.
Some key points to remember when you're assessing the situation on what to do about the problem is fetal oversize is very uncommon. That's something good to remember. Gravity is your friend. You can put the horse up on an incline, it would help the horse give birth. The decision on process what to do is the cervical status. Is it dilated or not? The cervix is fully dilated, you will not be able to see it, and that's a good thing. The placenta status, is it detached or not? Detached placenta usually means you're dealing with a dead fetus, which is something you need to be aware of. And the fetal status, is it alive or not? In most situations, it's best to focus on the survival of the mother. It is very difficult to get a live foal from a dystocia situation. Some things we can do about a difficult birth are we can vaginal delivery. We can just try to reposition the foal and try to see if it will come out on its own using gravity or any other tools that we can use. C-section is a very difficult decision to do because it's a very big procedure for a horse. And if the foal is not alive, the phlebotomy will be performed. It is a good idea to talk to your veterinarian about a referral hospital if you're dealing with a difficult situation as well.
Here are our sources for all of our research, and we're going to have a few questions for you guys to answer as well. So question 1, which of these is not a sign of dystocia in mares? A,
A, a bright red sac. B, colic leg signs. C, two front hooves visible. Or D, abnormal vaginal discharge. The answer for this one is C. Two front hooves visible is what we would like to see whenever we are delivering a foal, not a sign of dystocia. Question two is, what are your options if the fetus is non-viable, aka not alive? A, fetotomy. B, cesarean section. C, no human intervention at all. Or D, both A and B. The correct answer in this case is D. If you have a fetus that's not viable, fetotomy is often the safest and most cost-effective option. However, in some very complicated situations, C-section may be necessary.